We have detox or cleanses that is doing the rounds right now, and these detoxes or cleanses, they claim that they clean your body, your blood, and eliminate harmful toxins from your body. Unfortunately, that's not the case, but let's just know about what these detox diets do. Detox diets, they tend to last from any day, anything from 1 day to around a month, or maybe, and may involve fasting for a short period of time, consuming only fruits and vegetables, cutting out wheat and dairy, consuming a limited range of food, avoiding caffeine and alcohol, or detox solutions like pills, lotions, or even like there are detox teas now. So this whole claim about it cleaning your body and detoxing your body, and otherwise your body is full of toxins, and only if you're on this detox diet after Diwali or after Christmas or after Thanksgiving will your body function better. Unfortunately, that's not how our body works. That's the fun fact of the day. Our bodies have detoxic systems in place that eliminate toxins 24/7. Whether you're asleep, whether you're awake, these detox systems in your body will always be there for you, and they're always clearing out all the toxins in your body. If they didn't exist, if they were not functioning 24/7, there's no better way to put it, but you'd be dead by now. And these kind of detox systems are your liver and your kidneys. That is the only thing you need to detox stuff from your body. The liver's function is to detoxify a lot of the toxins and everything that come. Kidneys also help in the detoxification process. You don't need anything else. Unfortunately, detox drinks, detox waters, all of that don't work too much. They don't have too much scientific data either. So these juice cleanses that a lot of people go on, they kind of do more harm than good. They are low in calories. They're liquid meal replacements, and although they provide some amount of vitamins, there's no fiber in the diet that you go on these when you go on these cleanses. There's no protein. There's no fat in the diet, so it's not recommended. What you can do instead of wasting money on detox, detoxes, and other crazy diets is support the actual heroes of the actual people who the actual organs that detox your body, which are your liver and your kidneys. You crowd your diet with fruits and vegetables, reduce alcohol consumption, and drink adequate water to support your kidneys. That is a better way of supporting and cleaning your body than anything else. Not at all. It's not okay. No, because as we said, it's low in calories. You're not getting the calories that you would usually get in the day. I don't I it, There's no reason to do it, because there's nothing like detox. Detox doesn't exist. Only your livers and kidneys are the ones that actually do the detoxification. Detox juices don't work. They're a fad, and they don't work. So it's not, and also then you're also getting into a very, very, very disordered eating pattern and an unhealthy relationship with food. What happened on the 11th day? So basically, it's baseless to do a 10-day food challenge where you completely eliminate a certain food group, because what happens on the 11th day is that because in those 10 days where you're completely eliminating it and you're saying, I'm not going to eat this, I'm just so fixated on not eating it, that all you're thinking about is how after the 10 days are over, I'm only going to like binge on the 11th day, and I'm gonna over it's okay if I overeat because I've been so good in these 10 days of not eating carbohydrates. We've already discussed that carbohydrates is a very, very important part, no matter what, it's a very, very important part off our diet. We need carbohydrates to survive. We need carbohydrates and glucose for our brains to work optimally. So it makes no sense to do these 10-day. And also it leads to this binge restrict cycle, as we spoke about. Then you binge, then you feel guilty, then again you just start restricting into a very, very strict diet, and then again you go back. Again you binge because you've been so strict and so good, and it's just a crazy cycle that keeps going on and on, which may lead to disordered eating or an eating disorder, which is a severe psychological condition.